Hey everybody, Mrs. Samurai here, wanting to talk about how to control your fridge. Now, I don't necessarily mean how you have everything laid out inside of your fridge like this, but how to set those sometimes mysterious controls. They come in all kinds, like simple dials to kind of mysterious side knobs that pop in and out. Some of them are a little more space-age looking. And then others are these kind of simple dials with nice instructions written there. Setting your controls on your refrigerator isn't too complicated, but we do get asked by quite a few customers what the refrigerator should be set at. And I think the confusion comes in because, except for some newer models today that do actually show the temperature that you want the refrigerator to be at, that's how you set the control. Most units out there still just have controls with numbers between 1 and 7 or 1 and 5, something like that. Now this guy, apparently his family got so confused about what the controls meant that he added his own little labels trying to help them out. Okay, let's get down to business. First of all, I should point out that if you have your user's manual, they'll explain what you should do to set your controls, although in my extensive research preparing for this video, I found that most manufacturers seem to say exactly the same thing, and there's not a lot of detail. So I think there's still a lot you can learn from this video, so keep watching. We'll start with my refrigerator. Okay, here we go into my refrigerator. It's happens to be an Amana, almost 8 years old, I think. The French doors with freezer on the bottom. But I think you find the controls are similar to a lot of others out there in that we have numbers to deal with here, and we've got one for the freezer, one for the refrigerator, and that goes from 1 to 7, the 7 being the coldest setting. And the instruction book says to, if it was a brand new refrigerator, to set both of these at 4, and then change them up or down in order to maintain the proper temperatures. And then they tell you what those are, which is about, say, 36 to 40 degrees in the fresh food compartment and ideally 0 degrees in the freezer. Well, how are you supposed to know what your temperatures are if you don't have one of these guys? Now, when I very first opened the door, it was a little bit colder, but I've been standing here talking for about a minute. But it's still at 40, not too bad. And I'm sure you have watched my video on staying out of the danger zone. It's that yellow zone there. So basically, when you have thermometers in your refrigerator, both in the fresh food compartment and the freezer, then you can make sure you're in the proper zones by simply adjusting the controls up or down. And what my book recommends, and again, the same instructions I found over and over again for all kinds of manufacturers and models, is to just adjust one click up or down and then let the refrigerator be for up to 24 hours. I'd say at least, you know, overnight probably, and see where the temperatures fall out, because it does take a little time for it to adjust.
So instead of waiting to discover frozen lettuce or frozen milk, or frozen everything, or on the other end, warm stuff. Just get you one of these. It'll save you so much trouble and make sure your food stays fresh. The other mistake many people make, besides not having a thermometer in their refrigerator, is to think that they can just set the controls somewhere and then leave them be. Set it and forget it. But nope, that doesn't work because conditions change. And we've got to be willing to change with them. So throughout the year, of course, the seasons change, which means the ambient conditions in your house will change. So as it gets warmer and more humid, you may have to change the controls to keep the temperatures where you want them, as your fridge is having to work a little more against the elements. So that is one of the major reasons that prompts needing to change the controls. And the other one is how you load your refrigerator. So maybe you've crammed too much into your refrigerator and it's struggling, or you've switched the kinds of things you're keeping in the refrigerator. or some other circumstance that really ought to be dealt with, it might take a click or two of the control buttons to keep your fridge and freezer in the right zones. So that's all there is to it. Not too complicated. Just make sure you have your thermometers, pay a little attention, click the buttons now and then, and keep the cat in front of the fireplace. Thanks for watching. I hope you'll watch my other videos on how to maintain your appliances and treat them well so that they'll treat you well back. Until next time.